Greetings. If you are planning to become pregnant or are already pregnant, the fear of giving birth to an autistic child may be freaking you out, right? Well, unfortunately, you are not alone in having these fears, and there are good reasons to be worried. The United States is in the midst of an autism epidemic, and it is getting worse every day. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, just between 1994 and 2004, the number of 6 to 17-year-old children classified as having an autism spectrum disorders in public special education programs increased from 22,000 to over 193,000. That is an 850% increase in autism incidents in just 10 years, while autism on this dramatic scale wasn't even on the radar just a generation ago. Besides, full-blown autism is just the tip of the iceberg. According to the same source, approximately 13% of children have a developmental disability, ranging from mild disabilities such as speech and language impairments to serious developmental disabilities. So, what gives? What is actually the nature of autism, or, as this condition is formally called, autism spectrum disorders? According to the Merck Manual of Diagnosis and Therapy, a leading medical textbook in the United States, autism spectrum disorders are neurodevelopmental disorders characterized by impaired social interaction and communication, repetitive and stereotyped patterns of behavior, and uneven intellectual development, often with intellectual disability. Well, neurological development begins in the fetus and continues until the child is about 36 months old. How well this development goes depends mainly on four factors: maternal nutrition before, during, and after the pregnancy, and the child's nutrition after breastfeeding is over. In other words, there are four life stages that will ultimately determine your baby's brain development. Stage 1 is maternal nutrition before pregnancy. During this time, your body builds up the deposits of minerals and microelements required for fetal development and ensuing breastfeeding. Deficiencies in iodine, zinc, iron, and copper are implicated in neurological disorders at all stages of fetal development and lactation. Foods and supplements during pregnancy and breastfeeding may not provide enough of these essential micronutrients to satisfy your actual requirements because the ongoing high demand may exceed your body's ability to assimilate them. Stage 2 is prenatal nutrition. In addition to the microelements I have already mentioned, the deficiency of essential fatty and amino acids, vitamins A, B6, and B12, has been implicated in autism and developmental disorders. These nutrients have limited or no stores in the body at all and are derived almost exclusively from what you are eating daily while pregnant. Also, a number of preventable nutrition-related disorders may happen between conception and delivery and cause irreversible neurological damage. Among the most common are salmonella and listeria poisoning, exposure to mercury in fish, pernicious anemia related to nausea and vomiting during pregnancy, gestational diabetes, and blood disorders that may cause fetal stroke. Stage 3 is breastfeeding. The quality of your milk depends entirely on your daily nutrition. Low-quality breast milk causes infant malnutrition that in turn may damage the baby's brain. This is how the Merck Manual of Diagnosis and Therapy describes this pathology. Inadequately fed infants and children are at risk of protein, energy, undernutrition and deficiencies of iron, folate, vitamin A and C, copper, and zinc. I'll explain the outcomes of these deficiencies in just a few seconds. And finally, stage 4 is your child's nutrition after breastfeeding is over, and it lasts more or less until the end of the 36 months. During this time, children often experience acute diarrhea and may not assimilate any essential nutrients for days at a time. That is because solid foods are no match for breast milk in terms of quality and ease of digestion and assimilation. the rapidly ensuing malnutrition is bad enough to cause irreversible brain damage in as little as 5 to 10 days. The connection between malnutrition and the most tragic symptoms of autism or even milder developmental disabilities are beyond clear to anyone familiar with this condition. To connect the dots for yourself, just consider the following excerpts from mainstream medical references. Let's start with iodine. Severe maternal iodine deficiency retards fetal growth and brain development, sometimes resulting in birth defects, and in infants causes cretinism, which may include mental retardation, deaf mutism, difficulty walking, short stature, and sometimes hypothyroidism. Just for the record, iodine deficiency also happens to be a leading cause of infertility and miscarriage. A wholesale recommendation to avoid table salt, the primary source of iodine in the American diet, exaggerates iodine deficiency even more. Zinc deficiency is just as devastating. In children, it causes impaired growth and impaired taste. That is, incidentally, why autistic children often refuse foods, and this makes malnutrition even worse. Folate deficiency is next. It may cause diarrhea, depression, and confusion. Anemia may develop insidiously and, because of compensatory mechanisms, be more severe than symptoms suggest. And as they say, when it rains, it really pours. Iron deficiency, an already widespread problem in the United States, even among healthy children and adults, makes folate-dependent anemia even worse, and it happens to be an important cause of decreased attention span, alertness, and learning. A deficiency in essential amino acids, also called primary proteins, are our next culprit. It causes a condition called marasmus. It is described as a progressive wasting of the body occurring chiefly in young children and associated with insufficient intake or malabsorption of food. Marasmus is also behind mental retardation and autism-related irritability. Finally, a deficiency of essential fatty acids causes growth retardation in children. This deficiency usually happens while transitioning a child from breast milk to solid foods. And guess what organ has the highest concentration of essential fatty acids? The brain, of course. As you can clearly see, this unmistakable, incontrovertible associations between the most devastating symptoms of autism spectrum disorders and prenatal and pediatric nutrition have actually been known for ages, and one must be stone deaf to dismiss them. And this brings us to the final question. So what can you do today to avert autism from permanently damaging three lives, your own, your husband's, and your baby's? Well, actually quite a lot. First, if you are not yet pregnant, begin by eliminating all possible causes of maternal undernutrition. Besides autism, this effort will also prevent non-genetic infertility and birth defects, pregnancy complications, and premature aging. Second, if you're already pregnant or breastfeeding, apply the core principles of fertility-centric nutrition to your own diet now. It is never too late, particularly if you are concerned about your health, weight, appearance, aging, and stamina. Finally, if you're already giving your baby solid foods, learn how to do it right and how to safely prevent chronic digestive disorders and juvenile diabetes that are also behind autism spectrum disorders, retarded growth, and developmental disabilities. To learn more about autism prevention, maternal undernutrition, and fertility-centric nutrition, please visit my website. In turn, I look forward to helping you and your spouse to grow smart, happy, and healthy child.